Good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen. Assalamualaikum. Okay, welcome again to our video channel, our YouTube channel, sorry. Okay, today we are going to be talking about the most basic type of website if you're running a business that you should have, which is a brochure type of website. I think, okay, why if you're running a business, you need a brochure type of website? Okay, let's say you meet someone, you know, you pass over your business card to that person. What do you think he will do after that? Probably you can have 1 or 2 minutes of your time to see him, when you see him to tell a bit about your company. But what do you think he will do after that? He will probably go back to his office or go home, and he will Google your company on the internet. And let's say he doesn't find your information of your company on the internet. What does it show about your company? Number one, it will show that you are probably not a technology person, so you don't believe on the internet. Secondly, the most important thing that the person, or rather the potential customer that you met, will have a negative thinking about your company. He will think that you probably have something that you want to hide about your company, that you do not want to share to the world. You do not want to be transparent about your company. The information. If you are so secretive about your company, the rest of the world, it shows that you're not transparent enough. So why would somebody do business with you if you are not being transparent to them? So that's the most important thing. Your credibility is actually being questioned if people could not find information about your business on the internet. That's the first thing you need to do. Okay, that's why you need to have a brochure type website. Okay, second reason why if you're running a business, you need a brochure website. Do you know that if you don't have a website, how do you tell about your business to the rest of to your potential customer? What probably you'll do is you'll print out your company profile, or you print out brochures and start distributing it to customers. Have you ever calculated the cost of printing a company profile or a brochure? Let's take, for example, you are printing a color brochure. Typically, a color printing over here is going to cost between 80 cents to 1 ringgit per page. If you're going to print 20 pages about your company information, that's going to cost you about 20 ringgit. So 20 ringgit is going to cost you 20 ringgit to print a company profile. Okay, so if you are distributing, say for example, 10 profile a month or 20 profile a month, you do the calculation, it's going to be 400-500 ringgit easily a month just distributing your company profile to the various customers, also the various prospects. So imagine that, how much can you save in terms of printing costs? And furthermore, when you talk about printing costs, you're talking about, you know, physically handing over the brochure, the profile to your potential customers. If they are not near your place of business, you may need to add additional cost to it, which is the postage cost or the courier cost that you need to send to your potential customer. So there's all these costs being, you know, added to just to convey the information about your company. So if you don't have a profile on the internet, this is what you're going to do. But if you have profile on the internet, if somebody wants to find out about your company, you just send him your web address. That's it, he will find out about your company. So you will save on your printing by having your own website on the internet. So those are actually the two main reasons why if you're running a business, at least you need a basic information type of website. So what sort of information do you want to portray on the website? As a basic, you will want to show to the rest of the world who you are, who is behind the company, the person running the company, for example, the mission of the company, the vision of the company, the registration of the company with, for example, in Malaysia, the Company Commission of Malaysia, the formal registration of the company. Okay, the location of the company, where it's located, the map to the company, the office, the place of business, the services that your company is offering to the public, the products that they are offering. Okay? When you talk about the product, maybe a bit more detail on the specification of the product being offered. What else? So all this information are very important to a potential customer, to a prospect, to analyze whether they want to do business with the company or not. So I think as a minimum, if you're running a business today in 2019, you must have at least a brochure to your website. Spend some money, invest a bit on getting your information online. At least with that information online, people will find out more about your company, and from there they will decide whether they want to work with you or not. So hopefully you like my video. If you like the video, please subscribe to our channel and please like the video. Hopefully we'll see again with some other tips on online internet marketing. Thank you very much.